were both in a very dark place, and I think that our friend Akmini also shared the fact that she was in a dark place in her life at one point. And Didi, how much do you weigh during your V2, if you don't mind? I know it's kind of personal, but...
I was teeter-tottering between 244 and 246 pounds.
44, 246. Well, you don't look like you're 244, 246 right now. Does she look like she weighs 244? No. So here's the thing, guys. So when we were in UV2, I was about 168, I think, or 172, or 175, or something like that. I was teeter-tottering too. But, so we filmed UV2, and then, at the end of UV2, we were both invited to be in this upcoming program that's going to be released in 2018, To Be Mindset. Woo! Yes. Guys, this program is life-changing.
Yes.
You heard Lakmini's story, and now I'm going to turn it over for Dee to share her story, because with the To Be Mindset, you have lost how much again?
63 pounds and counting.
So, to be continued. To be continued, absolutely. So I'm just gonna turn it over to you, Didi, because I really want you to share, you know, because when I first, like I said, when I first met you, you were your heaviest weight. I know you were going through, you were in some dark moments in your life, and who you were back then and who you are today, two different people. And it's not just the physical that I've seen transform, it's your confidence level. Your smile just got brighter. And you know, when you speak with so much conviction. So clearly, there was a transition from the UV2 days to who you are today. So I would love for you to share what happened between that dash, you know, the dash between that start day and to be. Okay, so I'll tell you what to do.
Hey everybody, so glad you guys made it out today. Thank you, Mickey, for having me on your wonderful show. I love that show. It's always entertaining, something new. I find it so weird to hear this because I didn't know that Lakmini as well was in a dark place, and I find so weird. A lot of people, the majority of people, when their weight goes beyond their comfort zone, it seems like we are all battling something. And it may be a job, it may be a loved one, it may be a loss. But it's always something mentally and internally going wrong with you at that present state that where your weight spirals out of control. For me, I was an emotional eater, and I still sometimes have to check myself. I have to get my life because it's like, it's a lifestyle change. So it's something that you, you know, you battle with. Just as such as, you know, being an alcoholic or an overeater or a drug abuser. It's a thing that you have personally that you have to always battle. But now I battle with my mindset and with God. And I hope I don't offend anybody, but that's just who I am. I am able to overcome this. I'm able to be a conqueror and win this. I mean, I have PCOS. And women with PCOS know that sometimes when those hormones don't act right, everything seems like it's out of your control.
So, Didi, PCOS, just in case, because honestly, I didn't know what the heck PCOS was when you kept talking about it. She could say PCOS, I'm like, I have no idea what she's talking about, because clearly I was talking about that. Can you just share really quickly, because it seems that there's a lot of people out there, a lot of women that suffer from this, and for the men that are here, you know, maybe your wife has that condition, and I think it's really important that we educate ourselves and understand what's going on. So can you share just a little bit of what that PCOS is, and you know, where your mindset was before the journey, because I want to take everyone on a train ride.
I come from full-figured family. Most of the women are morbidly obese. They didn't start off that way, but they end up that way. And I've always kind of tried to watch what I eat and be mindful of what I'm doing, working out. And for a while, it was fine. But when I reached a certain age, I started just picking up this weight. the reason why I noticed it is because I was getting on the scale regularly because I had to go to the doctor because I was trying to find out what's going on with this weight. I would go in every week and my weight was jumping up 5 to 4 pounds a week. That's a lot. So they did some tests and come to find out I have this condition called PCOS. Now, I didn't know what it was. I had heard about it, but didn't know about it. And it stands for polycystic ovarian syndrome. So what that means is that you're basically a woman's hormones are all over the place. And one of the main signs of PCOS is weight gain. Almost everyone that I know suffers from PCOS, that is the one symptom that they all share. Now there's also horrible acne. I mean acne that's like cystic pimples, things that you would get when you were a teenager, that you're in your 30s and 40s and 50s and you have this acne that you seem to just can't get rid of no matter what you try. There's also hair. Most women don't want hair anywhere but on their head, and you will see women with straight out mustache and beard, and some have grown to accept it and some just don't like it, but it seems like there's nothing they can do because their hormones have a mind of their own. Other women, it may be hard for them, difficult for them to conceive because they don't know when they're ovulating because their menstruation is not regular, so they can't keep up, or some don't have one at all, you know? So there's a lot of different symptoms. Not everyone has the same symptoms, not everyone has all of those symptoms, but that weight gain symptom, you know, because you can get your hair waxed, okay? You can put on makeup and cover up pimples, but weight gain, you can't hide that for too long, and it does something to you mentally and physically to carry that and struggle with it. So when I got diagnosed with PCOS, and knowing that most of the women in my family are obese anyway, I was in a dark place. I said, why am I even trying? I'm doomed to be overweight. I'm doomed to have, you know, feel like I'm going to vomit when I bend over to tie my shoe because my belly is constantly in the way. I'm doomed to be unhappy in the skin I'm in. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm a happy person and I love myself, but I knew because I was not always morbidly obese that I was not happy with my body. I knew I was unhealthy and I felt it. Everything I did from just walking down the street, from being able to walk normal to feel like I was wobbling, I felt it in everything I did. When I put on my clothes, how things just felt like they were cutting into my skin and it was uncomfortable. So I was unhappy with that, and that spilled into other aspects of my life as far as my whole relationships, you know, with my loved one. It spilled into my professionalism of my jobs, my acting began to suffer, I was not looking to work. And it's just crazy how one thing, as far as your weight, that whole mental and physical thing, it spills into all aspects of your life.
Thank you so much for sharing all that. So clearly, I mean, I'm just listening to you, and I can only imagine the frustration that you must have been feeling before you started this journey. Can you share with us, how did Beachbody then step into the picture and change your life?
I'm gonna try to keep it short because I just smile. So the thing is, you know, and we have to remember this, Beachbody first off is amazing, but it's more than just the product. It's the people behind it. It's, you know, because you can do any program, and if you do it and stick with it, you'll lose the weight. Now, most things that are out there are, I mean, honestly, because I've tried a lot of things, it's just not realistic that you're going to do it for the rest of your life, let's be honest. I'm sorry, but I don't want to count points everywhere I freaking go. I don't want to think about points. I don't want to think about measuring. I don't want to think that I have to have 3 shakes and, you know, a shake for breakfast, a shake for, like, come on, I want to eat. I like to eat. I'm going to be real with myself. I'm not going to be taking, you know, 2 shakes for my meal where it ain't not even healthy. And when I smell them, I feel like I'm about to vomit and I got to force myself to get it down. I'm not going to do that for the rest of my life. It's not going to happen. So I've been there, you know, and I've tried other things that had a shake, but you had to take all this other stuff. Like, you got to take these pills. You got to be like, I don't want to do that for the rest of my life. That's not how I want to live my life. I want to enjoy my life. I want to eat for my health, you know, not to eat just to be eating. So the thing about Beachbody is not that they just taught me so much about my body, and it's so weird because we're adults and we think we know about our bodies, but we don't know not a damn thing about our bodies. And so you learn how to eat, how you learn what to eat and what you're eating, how it affects your body. But the people behind it, that company, the people who started it, and the coaches and the team, that makes all the difference in the world. Honestly, the Beachbody, the product is amazing. It works, hands down, I'm a witness. But without the people behind it, the coaches, the teammates, it's nothing. That made all the difference in the world for me. That accountability, that family tie. I am closer to some of these people in my team than I am to my own family. They get me on a whole nother level that my family couldn't understand. That support is key. It really is. It's key to whatever you do in your life, because I strongly believe we were not meant to go through anything alone. If that was the case, God would have stopped at Adam and the animals. Eve would not be here. We're meant to do these things together. There is no I in team. I say it all the time. Even though you are entirely up to you, you still need your family to help you be the best who you can be. We're not meant to do it alone. So that's what I think about Beachbody. I think about family. I think about love, growth, encouragement. Because the thing is, you can have a family and you're not getting that from them. You know, I mean, don't get me wrong, I have a great family, but they're all the way in Illinois. I live right here in New York. And the thing is, even with that, I have challengers that live in Illinois. And I'm still close to them, even though I'm in New York. There's something about that family and that mentality that switches and changes everything.
So much, Judy. So, lastly, I want to just ask you, so 63 pounds gone, PCOS, you seem to control it. It doesn't control, right? It's not controlling you any longer. You are controlling it. How has this changed your life? I mean, I know that clearly you love me like I'm your sister. Thank you so much. I forgot to say that. I was waiting for you to say that. So clearly you have a new family within the Team Beachbody, but I know that one of the roles of your life is you're an actress, and 63 pounds gone, PCO is under control. How has that changed your life now? Because I'm sure it's not just the physical, like what else has changed? Mindset, your jobs, everything. You can just share one or two things.
I'm so happy about this. I thank God, first off, because honestly, he just put the right people in my life. But I moved here from Illinois, and my acting I'm knock on wood, I'm not tooting my own horn, but I'm a good actress. But this is New York City, and there are so many other good actresses. You know, like almost everyone here is in some type of fine arts. And it was hard, and it still is hard. But my confidence, and like, don't get me wrong, I had confidence, but I still felt like, well, okay, I'm the biggest one in the room. Everywhere I go, I'm the biggest one in the room, you know. Something about that, it doesn't even matter. I can still go places and be the biggest one in the room, but I'm also the finest one in the room. I'm the happiest one in the room. I'm at peace with myself. I know I'm constantly growing in the right direction. And that confidence, somebody told me, what did they say? Something about confidence, the way that they said it was like, confidence is the new sexy, confidence is the new thin. There is nothing like confidence. And it started with me regaining my self-worth. I forgot it. Can you guys relate to that? If you think about a time where you kind of just lost your self-worth, like you know you're worth something, but you didn't treat yourself like you was worth something. You know, you kind of just forgot how to treat yourself. And I regained my self-worth. I won't stand for certain BS anymore.
I know how to check myself before I wreck myself. Like, Didi, why are you doing that? Get your life. I have to do that sometimes, and it's okay. My confidence, when you have confidence, honey, you got money. Even though you don't have money, you got money. You got a car, even if you're taking public transportation, you got a car. You got whatever you feel you have. I'm serious. You may not have the clothes you want, but you put it on, honey, you got whatever you think you got on, you got on. That confidence, nothing beats it. Nothing beats it. So lastly, I know that we have some guests that are here, some people that we have a lot of cameras here, there's people going Facebook Live. Can you speak to that person out there that's been sitting on the fence, not too sure, you know, should I join, you know, should I say yes to the invitation? Can you share with them why they should say yes to changing their lives, to say yes to their coach that invited them, to end the year strong? You know, we still have 6 strong weeks to end the year, and we don't give up now. Now's when we get stronger. So just share.
I feel like if you are at that point where you're on the fence, or you're just at that point where you're like, I'm really just fed up and I'm tired of trying, now is the time. This is your time. That's that little voice in your head. It's really just the time to do it, because this is the thing. And if you're anything like me, I'm a very frugal person. I'm always trying to save, save, save. You have nothing to lose. You have nothing to lose. You won't lose your money, okay? You won't lose yourself. You're gonna gain a family. You're gonna gain a whole supportive family, for real. And you have nothing to lose but the unwanted inches or the unwanted pounds. Or maybe it's not even weight, maybe you're just an unhealthy person. So now you wanna gain back that healthy mentality and a healthy nutrition and just get your life back on track. There's so much you're gonna get besides the weight loss, your confidence, your energy, your strength, your outlook, your mindset. All of that stuff plays into every aspect of your life. I know, even me, I'm still a work in progress, but I know someone who's out there, they are unhappy. And it can be unhappy with everything, it can be unhappy with one thing, but I promise you this, I promise you this. You get your health on track, everything falls into place. It ain't nothing like being healthy. People are out there trying to steal other people for their healthy parts. Like, let's be real. It is nothing like having your health. You can't buy it. You can't buy it. You control your health. Get your life before you can't get it back.
Wow.
Get your life.
Wow.
Thank you, Didi. Thank you so much for sharing. Guys, thank you so much for staying and listening to 2 amazing stories today. And guys, it all boils down to making one decision. That one decision to say yes to yourself, to your life, to your health. It takes one decision, not just to change your life, but to change and inspire other people to take control back of their life. And this is the platform to do it. You have nothing to lose and everything to gain. So thank you so much. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Oh, we have one more raffle? Okay.
Thanks for joining me.